she went and feed the pigeons. Please, I wish you wouldn't feed the pigeons.
Huh?
I wouldn't mind if the pigeons...
Are you a mugger?
No. I'm not a mugger. I'm just trying to tell you that...
Because if you are, you might as well just mug me and get it over with.
I'm just trying to tell you, madam, that...
I have a very loud voice. I love to scream. But if you really want to hear it, you've got to mug me.
I don't want you feeding the pigeons because I saw pigeons on 79th Street and this covey of pigeons, that's what you call a bunch of pigeons, a covey. They were foaming. They were foaming at the mouths, all of them.
Uh-huh.
At the beaks. They were foaming at the beaks.
I'll watch out.
I'm very hungry, and I'd hate to see you feeding pigeons when I'm so hungry. A Cracker Jack at this point would be a feast.
They're not pigeons. They're geese.
You're very perceptive.
I've been in this city 11 months now. And you're the first person I've spoken to that's spoken to me. 11 months of silence till now.
Well, everything I've said is true.
Please, don't go.
And that's when we met, 2 weeks ago. We walk in the park, and we talk about the future.
It's autumn and winter and spring and orange and green and blue and no leaves are all over.
I think she still thinks I'm a mugger.
He doesn't know where I live, and I don't know where he lives.
I live in a doorway.
He has his life, and I have mine.
Except for today, Sunday. We walk in the park, we talk about the future, and we never mention the past.
I don't care if he's a mugger or not. My life isn't great, but Sundays are okay. I like him very much. He's a very odd person, an odd duck, you might say. But he does tell me awfully funny stories.
I tell her stories.
Stop.
Like... But she doesn't like to talk about the past, so we just talk about the future.
I think he thinks I'm beautiful, which I'm not, but whatever.
I make her think I think she's beautiful, but she's not. But more so when I tell her that she is.
But mostly, we just talk about the future.